Hey, Australia.
Hey, Japan.
Hola, Portugal.
Whoa, whoa.
Hello, England.
Hello, Canada.
Hello, Brazil.
Hey, Germany.
Check out this Kindlekins album.
Oh, Nelly.
Bonjour.
I hope you think I'm posh.
Me llama Nelly Furtado.
Chama, whoa, Nelly.
Whoa.
Nelly.
I grew up in a wonderfully diverse culture where I could eat authentic Chinese food and then go to like a Bhangra East Indian dance that night. And the next week I'd be like at a Latin dance. So I was exposed to all different kinds of music. It's pretty amazing.
And I'm sorry that I made myself feel better by making you.
I grew up in Victoria, BC, which is on Vancouver Island. So I'm a West Coast girl.
I know you'll shine much brighter.
I was singing in Portuguese, performing in Portuguese before English, so I was always had like kind of folkloric, melodic sort of Portuguese music. I was always around that too. The earliest stuff I remember listening to is very mainstream. Billy Joel and ABBA and Police and stuff like that. If there's any one genre that I'm like schooled on, it's R&B and hip hop. Like, hated Nirvana when they came out and stuff because they sabotaged my R&B station because it was Seattle station.
I heard Portishead and it really clicked something in me. I really loved it.
They kind of took elements of rock, like melancholic singing and subject matter and the emotionalness of it, and combined it with hip-hop and old jazz. It kind of made me feel like you didn't have to do one or the other. It was a genre that kind of came out and you could be both. Corner Shop Tucker came out, they combined pop music with East Indian music, which I thought was amazing. And so I thought, well, I want to make a pop record with Brazilian and Portuguese influences.
It's getting so lonely inside this bed. Know if I should lick my wounds or say it was me instead. But after midnight, morning will come. The day we'll see if you will get some.
I write really good songs when I go to sleep. Because you turn off the light and your mind's still going. And sometimes you just come up with like a whole idea. That's how I'm like a bird came to do too, just like 10 minutes or something. Usually start with a hook actually, or like the chorus, and then like work backwards. And then a lot of it comes together in the studio for me too.
I'm like a bird.
I was just singing I'm Like a Bird. And I love singing that song, and I was just thinking to myself, I've never sang an original of mine that I've written with so much passion before. And it's just got a pure vocal and a great register for me to sing in, and I wrote it, and I like the bridge. I wrote a good bridge, you know?
You're beautiful, and that's for sure. You'll never, ever fade. You're lovely, but it's not for sure. Though my love is great, though my love is true, I'm like a bird, I only fly away. I don't know where my soul is, I don't know where my home is.
When you make music for self for a really long time, you kind of develop a little bit of a complex. I like sold out or whatever, like because I'm making consciously making pop music and stuff like that. So Shit on the Radio is kind of about taking that step to doing music for the world, doing commercial music, because it's a huge step.
You'd like me to put my shit on the radio. Well, I hate to say, but I've been going solo. You'd like me to put my shit on the radio. But now I'm just a machine for you, oh no. You like me till you see me on your TV. Well, if you're so low below, then why you watching? You say good things come to those who wait. I've been waiting a long time for it. I remember the days when I was so eager to satisfy you. Be less than I was just to prove. Walk beside you, now that I've blown away, I see you
hip-hop because it was kind of genre-less, because I wasn't quite cool enough to make, like, rock music. Like, I wasn't quite cool enough to make underground music because I knew that my things I came up with were very melodic and very catchy. I couldn't get around them. I'd come up with really good hooks. Song, it's like, oh, stay true to myself, myself, and it's true. I feel that now that I'm kind of making music on my own terms and just kind of like not bounded by any one genre, I think pop music is very diverse. Like, pop music is a whole universe. It can kind of be anything under that umbrella. It comes down to good songs.